chote utataka nitakupa.
Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. It's your girl Fanny Lungu back with another reaction video. If you're new to this channel, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe. Like I said, my name is Fanny Lungu, and on this channel, we post reaction videos each and every day. So if there's anything specific that you want us to react to, drop us the link in the description box below. Not description, but comment box below, and we'll actually do it for you. Thank you to everyone that subscribed to us. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for watching. Thank you for sharing, and just thank you for everything. So today we're actually going to be reacting to Shamsi versus missionary who accuses Prophet Abraham of adultery. Speaker's corner. So without wasting time, let's get into the video.
Does God order the people to do evil?
No, God doesn't. God is good.
Would you walk naked That's in the streets? naked, I mean, with your private out, everything.
That's not my habit, though.
No. Is that something moral or immoral for children and women? It's immoral, man. Immoral. No one here walk naked showing his private parts. 49 years old. To children, babies. However, you God in the Bible, Isaiah 23, he said to Isaiah to walk naked for 3 years. Is that immoral or moral, man? See? That's how I don't speak about it.
I'll check it out.
I like the silence.
I'll check it out.
Check it out, please.
Isaiah 23.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Then the Lord said, just as my servant Isaiah has gone stripped and barefoot for 3 years, 3 years walking naked. That's the prophet of God, they believe. And they call him the prince of the prophets. So Christians, you have no leg to stand on to speak about our prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's why he was scared to speak about it. Why? Because if I show him this, therefore he cannot criticize Prophet Muhammad anymore. How can you speak Prophet Muhammad in action when you have your prophet, your God Jesus, said to a man to walk naked for 3 years?
I can't find it in mine. Where is it? I can't find it.
Maybe it's a different Bible.
Where is it? Isaiah 23.
You can't.
Sorry, 20 verse 3.
Okay. It's okay, it's alright.
I don't think I should say he was naked, does it?
Yeah, barefoot. He was stripped and barefooted.
He took off his robe.
Okay. Took everything.
He took his robe. He took off his sandals.
No. Look, depends what translation you're reading.
Yeah.
Says he was. Look, my servant Isaiah has been walking around naked and barefoot for the last 3 years.
Yeah,
this is a sign, a symbol of the terrible troubles will bring upon Egypt and Ethiopia. So that was a sign as he's a true prophet. So according to the Bible, true prophets can walk naked. So if you walk naked, you are a true prophet.
Maybe he was truly naked, I don't know. Or maybe it's just figuratively. You know,
no, not figuratively, he was naked. He was naked.
Oh, I know.
According to the Bible, he was naked. You see, that's why I'm calling it Islam. That doesn't make any sense. God, the prophet of God, don't do this.
If we're talking about morality, I certainly won't come to Islam.
No, sadly not. Come. Give me any immorality based upon which, what criteria you are using, what criteria you are utilizing to determine what is moral and what is immoral according to what is in Islam.
I don't believe in having 3-4 wives. That is immoral.
Which criteria you are using by that?
What God has revealed to us.
Okay. So show me what God said.
God has revealed to us in the Torah, okay, in the prophets.
How many wives Abraham had?
We should have only one wife.
Abraham
had at least two wives, okay?
So was it?
He had one wife.
So according to the Torah, you have two wives, okay. One wife.
No,
but
no,
Abraham,
no, no, no.
Who was a prophet, had two wives.
No. Does the Bible ever say that it's a good thing?
Yeah.
No, it does not say that.
I tell you, it does.
That Abraham had his wife's servant girl.
No, don't say slept like that. Don't say slept like that.
He did sleep with his wife.
Yeah, but we don't speak like that about
prophets.
She was his wife.
She was his wife.
Jacob, how many wives Jacob had?
Yeah. The Bible describes people who sin, okay? It describes David sinning with Bathsheba.
It describes
many prophets who sin.
I'm speaking about that. Show me
just
where
as Muhammad sinned. No, wait. Only Jesus is without sin. Okay?
So is racism sin?
Only Jesus
is racism
without
sin.
Racism is definitely not right.
Yeah, no, ask you that. Is it sin?
Is it sinful?
So when Jesus called the woman,
because God has made all.
That's good.
Right.
So when Jesus called the Canaanite woman and he compared her to a dog, is that a good thing or a bad thing?
Well, he used a word which is for a saying. Okay, just like we say, don't look a gift horse in the mouth or don't throw your.
No, that was a racist term.
He used a saying which was common amongst the Jewish people at that time. The word dog is not racist. Okay?
So comparing a woman to a dog is not racism.
No, it wasn't racism.
Okay, that's
he was talking about a domestic pet.
He's not even talking about a wild dog. You know why I talk about Christians? Christians sometimes they make their own Bible. There's a Bible and you have your own Bible in your head.
If you think that Jesus is racist,
according to the Bible, yes.
You should not.
I give you the verses?
Let me give you the verses. How can you accuse Jesus of racism?
I didn't say according to the Bible it is.
No.
Let me finish. Jesus, a woman came to him.
Yes.
She asked him for help.
Yes.
The all-loving Jesus, all-loving God, remember?
Yes.
What he did, he ignored the woman. Then his followers told him, please, just help her and I go away from us. His friend had to beg him to help her. It was not from his own initiative to help her.
That's wrong. You're not telling the truth. Go read it. Go find it.
Because she was following them for long and he said, go help her. Then what he said to her, because she was a Canaanite woman, he said, I have only descent to the lost house sheep of Israel. Because she was a Canaanite woman. He said to her, you're not allowed to throw the bread to the dogs.
Did she take offense?
Did Jesus heal her? Did she request it? It's like me slapping you and say, give you cake.
You're suggesting.
Did she slap you though?
You're making accusations against Jesus.
Doesn't mean I give you cake, therefore my slap is okay.
Yes, Jesus.
So you, listen.
Which the Canaanite woman did not take offense at.
Take a long breath.
Okay.
Deep breath, take the deep breath. Okay, calm down. Wait, read it to us to show you that he compared the woman because she was an Israelite to a dog. Compare this.
He called his people snakes.
No, forget all of that. He's calling a woman because she's not an Israelite. Compare her to a dog. And remember, I'm going to ask him as well, in the Bible says, Abraham committed sin when he had two wives. You know, and what I notice about Christians, we lie, yeah? They will go against the Bible for the sake of rejecting Islam. Because they know if they accept some aspect in the Bible, they have to accept Islam, they will reject the Bible for the sake of rejecting Islam. Subhanallah. That's why you know Allah when he said, Ad-Dallin, Maghdub Alim.
Okay.
I didn't tell you to go look for the girl who died.
Okay,
I didn't ask you to go to look for the girl who lost in Spain. No. I need to look for a passage.
I'll read the passage for you.
Go on.
Okay, yeah. So, leaving that place, Jesus withdrew to a region of Tyre and Sidon. He was trying to get away from the crowds for a rest, okay? A Canaanite woman from that vicinity came out to him crying, Lord, Son of David, have mercy on me. My daughter is demon-possessed and suffering terribly.
Yes.
Jesus did not answer a word, so his disciples came to him and urged him, send her away, but she keeps crying out after us.
Who urged him? Who urged him? His disciples came to him and he urged him, send her away, she keeps coming to us. Because he ignored her.
He ignored her. So
where is the loving Jesus?
So the disciples asked Jesus to send her away.
Yes, so ignored, okay. Why? Because he ignored her.
Yeah, Jesus was not answering her, it's true.
He ignored her step by step. Yes. I know it's a deep word.
He did not answer her.
So where is the loving Jesus?
Okay, Jesus did not answer her. He was testing her faith.
Who's not testing her faith? The woman, she was strong.
She said, woman, you have great faith.
Yeah.
Your request is granted.
Yeah.
And her daughter was
after he ignored her for a long time.
Jesus did not answer her straight away.
But who told him to answer it? Did Jesus by himself? He stopped and he said, let me answer her. All his companions urged him to answer her. Which one is it?
His companions urged Jesus to send her away. But Jesus did not send her away as his disciples.
It was embarrassment. It was embarrassment. The woman after them begging him, and Jesus just ignoring her. It was embarrassment. They told you know what? Just
Jesus
send her away.
Didn't answer, and his disciples said, send her away.
I know it's hard for you. I know it's hard to digest it. Bit by bit,
instead,
to digest it. I'm going to help you to digest it.
Healed her daughter.
He commended her faith.
She did not take offense at Jesus.
Excuse me.
She did not consider Jesus.
You believe in the Bible? You believe in the Bible?
Okay, yes, of course.
So can you read the Bible?
Let's
read
what he said. The Bible is God's message to us.
Yeah, read what is in the Bible. Read the word in when he compared her to a dog. Can you read that, please?
Sorry, I just found it for you. Okay.
Just read it. I know it's hard to digest. I'm going to help you try to digest it bit by bit.
So the woman came and knelt before him. Lord, help me, she said. He replied, it's not right to take the children's bread and toss it to the dogs. Yes, it is, Lord, she said. Even the dogs eat crumbs that fall from the master's
table.
What did he say? He used this saying, okay, this proverb,
it is not right to take
the children's bread and toss it to the dogs.
To the dogs. So okay. He's comparing the woman to the dog.
Okay.
A'udhu billah.
Right.
Woman, she's coming for help. She's begging. So imagine someone coming for help. He said, no. I'm not going to give you something. I'm going to help you the way that, to give something to the dogs. Now, who is the mercy of Jesus? Who is the all-loving Jesus?
Jesus does heal her. Okay.
He commends her for her faith.
He is not rejecting her.
Come on, Julian.
Julian.
Go like clearly, man. I know it's hard, yeah. But clearly that Jesus, according to the Bible,
he
belittled the woman.
Jesus
clearly.
He disgraced the woman. She did not take offense. Instead, Jesus commended her.
He did what she asked. We're not going nowhere with this, yeah? Now,
yes.
Can you show me where God said to Abraham, you committed sin because you had two wives?
Well, it's quite clear in the scriptures
that
God's plan for us is one man and one woman.
I ask you that. Can you show me where God correct Abraham after he had two women?
Was it Solomon?
Abraham. Solomon don't believe his prophet.
Well, strangely, God, when God speaks about Abraham's children, he refers only to Isaac as Abraham's son.
Would he bless? Okay. He said, I will bless Ishmael.
Yes.
I'm not asking you that.
So,
show me where God.
Julian.
For me to carry on speaking to you because I'm going to walk off.
Isaac rather than Ishmael.
Show me where God said to Abraham, you commit sin when you had two women. Can you show us nicely, please? Because he said he was wrong. So can you show us?
Well, the Bible says you shall not commit adultery, okay?
I'm asking you a specific event.
If you have sex with any woman, it's not your wife.
So Abraham committed adultery?
Yes.
Show us who says that in the Bible.
Yes.
Show us who said, A'udhu billah, Ibrahim. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, you talk about Ibrahim like this. Prophet of God, father of the prophet, accused him of adultery. Yeah,
that's right, he sinned.
Yeah, adultery.
He didn't trust God.
That's why, according to the Bible, even Hitler can be prophet.
He did not trust God.
Stalin can be prophet, according to the Bible.
God had promised Abraham a son.
You say and you believe into the text. Again, can you ask us, show us where God said to Abraham, you have committed adultery. Go on.
No, he didn't say you are committed adultery.
So,
it's not recorded.
So you're accusing Abraham?
I am saying Abraham committed adultery.
A'udhu billah.
Yes.
Just for the sake of rejecting Prophet Muhammad, he's going to even accuse Abraham.
Muhammad was the ultimate adulterer.
Even the Christians, they will not take you serious. Do you know why?
Yes.
Because you just accused Abraham to be adulterer.
He's a sinner.
No, adulterer. Adulterer.
That's right. As
I said that in the Bible.
Adultery.
So you accuse the Prophet Muhammad of adultery, then the Christian will not take you serious. Because why?
Yes, they will.
You have a right.
Yes, they will.
You had a gut to accuse Abraham to be adulterer.
Because Christians do not believe that prophets are sinless. No, I'm fine.
Huh?
I'm fine. Don't worry.
Okay.
Yeah.
Take care of yourself.
Thanks
Julian
for the
will
offer.
Lie.
Thanks for the offer, but Christians do not believe prophets are sinless.
Julian. sorry.
Okay, only Jesus is sinless.
It's not sinless.
All the other prophets
are sinless. It's not sinless.
Okay. They committed sins.
No,
Moses
no. Prophet Muhammad is a sinless as well.
Moses killed a man.
Rasulullah is a 42 major sin. Rasulullah is a 42 major sin.
Muhammad did not. Muhammad committed many sins.
Let's change those
something.
Julian, this is the first time I spoke to you. What makes someone a prophet?
Muhammad was
committed. What makes someone a prophet?
Muhammad was commanded to ask for forgiveness.
Well, right, doesn't mean a sin. Doesn't mean sin.
So that means he had sinned. If he doesn't need to, ask for forgiveness. He is not sin.
I'll tell you, he doesn't have to. You know why? Let me explain to you.
He has to have sinned.
No, okay. Let me explain to you.
And I can see how he sinned.
No, I explain to you. Let me explain to you.
He had sex with Marianne the cop.
No, Julian, right? Let me explain to you. As a Muslim, seeking forgiveness doesn't mean you commit sin. What it does mean, it means that you're a person humbling yourself to God. And you know, regardless how much you pray and you worship God, you will never be able to repay back God what He has given you from the blessings and the mercy. For example, Julian, as a Muslim, after the prayer, we finish the prayer, straight away we say, forgive us God. We will not commit sin, we will pray Him. You know why? Because we know, regardless how much we pray, we are not perfect. We always fall into shortcomings. So what we do, we seek forgiveness from God. So seeking forgiveness in Islam doesn't necessitate someone is falling into sin. What it does, we are admitting that we cannot worship God perfectly. You understand that? The other thing I want to ask you, Julian, what makes someone a prophet?
Right, Muhammad was not a prophet.
Okay. I didn't ask about Muhammad, I'm asking, what makes someone a prophet? That's my question.
Criteria. A prophet is someone who has a message from God to give to the people. Okay.
Yeah, but if I say, so if I have a message and I say God gave it to me, how can you prove that I'm not?
I have to test whether you are a prophet.
So what is the criteria?
Okay. Well, according to the Bible, you have to be accredited by miracles.
Okay. Miracles.
Okay.
Step by step, so miracles, God. Yeah? But in the Bible, Jesus said even false prophets do miracles.
It's possible for false prophets.
So it's not criteria then?
That's not the only criteria. Okay, right.
So what is the second criteria?
Okay, so if you prophesy something and it is not, and it does not come to pass, for example, you say something is going to happen and it does not happen, that shows that your message is not from God. Okay.
So if it does happen, it means it's true prophet?
Obviously, not necessarily, but...
So what makes someone a prophet? Now, for example, Prophet Muhammad did a miracle. Do you accept it as a prophet?
Muhammad did miracles.
Yeah, he did split the moon.
No, he did not.
He did.
No, he did not.
He did, yeah.
No one ever recorded the moon ever being split.
No one recorded that the sea was split. halal for them.
There were only how many thousand Israelites there to witness it?
How many thousand?
How many thousand people witnessed Muhammad splitting the moon?
Wait.
Tell me. What? Show me any witness of Muhammad splitting the moon.
I'll show you.
Why is it that the Chinese astronomers don't find it? Why is it the Arabian?
Why did Egyptian astronomers never recorded it?
Why is the Persian astronomers didn't see the moon?
Yeah.
Why is no one on the earth see the moon split?
Watch this. To show the Christian they cannot be consistent. According to the Bible, when Jesus was crucified, that will happen, dead people come back to life and they will walk as a zombie, correct? How come no historian from the Greek recorded it?
Okay.
Jesus.
Huh? So you agree that Jesus
died? No. Wait. Ask me a question. You have miracles in your Bible which no one recorded it, even your gospel writers, no one recorded except one gospel writer.
Yes.
About the zombies walking, come back from the grave and walking the street.
Yeah, you're right. There's only one witness to that.
Who's it?
Okay. Who's it? The one witness to that. You're right.
You still believe in it?
But there was still a witness.
No, you still believe in it?
There was still a witness.
No. Do you still?
And people at that time could
question.
Go and ask.
No, ask them a question. Do you still believe in it?
No,
Hear me out. Do you still believe in it, even though there's one witness?
Well, yes, I do.
If I have one witness, be consistent.
Yes.
If I have one witness, the witness Prophet Muhammad split the moon, would you believe in it?
I have to take it very seriously, yeah.
I ask you that. Would you believe in it?
I'm not sure, but I will certainly take your evidence seriously.
This is Al-Bukhari, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. It was narrated by Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Prophet Muhammad's companion, Ibn Abbas, was narrated by him. Many companies narrated it.
So 250 years after Muhammad,
Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is not 200 years.
250 years later, someone said that Muhammad split the moon.
Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is not, 200 years. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is Prophet Muhammad's companion.
Yeah. Okay.
Wait. Let me ask you now.
Yeah.
What is the earliest manuscript for the Torah?
Oh.
1,000 years after Moses.
It's exactly.
1,000 years. So 1,000 years after Moses, someone said Moses split the moon. You believe in it?
Moses didn't split the moon.
Moses split the moon. No, sorry. You still believe in it?
You're talking about the Red Sea.
Do you believe in it?
Yeah, I do believe.
So you have no problem for someone to come 1,000 years after Moses and says that Moses split the moon, but you have a problem for the sake of argument, someone coming 200 years after Prophet Muhammad and said the moon split up.
Yeah. It's you'd have someone like that. When you agree with me,
that's what I'm showing, the double standard.
Other people to have seen it. Huh? If the moon was split, wouldn't you have expected it?
No, because that miracle was specific for the people of Quraysh. It was not for everyone. Even the hadith mentioned that. The hadith clearly stated that Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, the people of Quraysh, said to him, if you are a true prophet, then split the moon. Okay? But why so Julian, out of respect here, I'm all like, guys, the truth. What I see from the Christians here, and hopefully you don't get that disease, okay, because it's contagious, that what Christians do, they will try to reject anything from Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, and they will accept anything from Jesus, even if and guess their criteria of accepting and rejecting. Why? Why this hatred for our Prophet Muhammad ﷺ? Why?
Because he contradicted everything that Jesus did.
Let us analyze that. Prophet Muhammad ﷺ contradicted whatever Jesus did.
Jesus died upon the cross. He said that was his mission. Okay.
Said that. Who said that, by the way?
Jesus.
No. Who narrated from him?
Pardon?
Who? Jesus never told you that directly.
No, Jesus didn't speak to me.
Someone said it.
The scriptures.
Someone. Yeah, right. Who are they?
So the writers of the scriptures,
Mark, record. Luke, yeah. John, Matthew. Yeah. So Prophet Muhammad doesn't go and guess Jesus, he go and guess Mark and Luke and Matthew and John. Okay? So he doesn't go and guess Jesus.
And a Roman historian.
Hear me out, Julian. So, now Jesus go and guess the prophet of God.
So somehow Allah deceived the disciples of Jesus who wrote the Gospels. He deceived the other people around that Jesus had died. He deceived the Romans and the Jews that Jesus had died upon the cross. He deceived the mother of Jesus that her son had died upon the cross. He deceived Christians for hundreds of years. He deceived Christians that Jesus had died upon the cross.
No, we don't believe that. So let me clarify that.
What the Quran says?
No, doesn't say that.
It says that.
No. The Quran says.
Surah 4.
Yeah, no, yes. But you have to understand what it means. And now we know when they tried to crucify Jesus, Allah saved him and raised him. His disciples saw that. They saw that Jesus was saved. And did you know in the Bible, Hebrews 5:7, he mentioned.
Did Jesus die on the cross or not?
No, of course the Bible knows. According to Quran, no. And according to Hebrews 5:7, no.
So Allah deceived Christians.
No, he hasn't. No, he hasn't.
He deceives Christians even to today.
No, he hasn't.
By saying that Jesus died upon the cross.
No, you are deceived by John and Mark and Luke.
No,
hear me out. Now, can you go to Hebrew 5:7?
No.
Why? No. You know why?
I want to keep you on the subject.
Same subject. No. Hebrew 5:7 says, when Jesus was on the earth, he prayed to God to save him.
God heard him.
What does it mean?
And God heard him.
What does it mean?
Jesus said, not my will, but your will be done.
No, I'm not talking about
God
that.
God heard that prayer.
No. God saved
God
him.
God heard that prayer.
Let me read it.
Okay.
Let me read out the passages. Yeah? It mentions in Hebrew 5:7 that Jesus prayed to God. In his last day, when he was in flesh, in the earth, Jesus prayed to God to save him. Due to his reverence, God heard him. But we know God heard anyone, regardless if you are righteous or a wicked person. But why God mentions here, or what is mentions here, was heard because of his reverence. Meaning hearing of God means God accepted his prayer. That's why he saved him. And that
goes
in
line
in the Quran.
God accepted the prayer, not my will but yours be done.
And which he saved him.
So God did answer that prayer.
He saved him.
God answered the prayer.
Saved him.
It was not possible.
And no, it's hard to say. Saved him.
Through the resurrection.
No. Saved. No.
Jesus died.
If he died.
Resurrected.
No, if he died, there's no saving. No.
For him.
If he died, he was not saved. He was asking to be saved from crucifixion.
This is what being prophesied in the Old Testament. This is God's will.
It's not
Jesus.
No. In the Old Testament says.
If it's possible, take this cup away from me. But not my will, but yours be done. Okay? And God did hear that prayer. Okay?
So he saved him.
So that it was not possible for Jesus not to suffer.
Did God save him or not? My question.
Jesus died upon the cross.
So God didn't save him?
Jesus died upon the cross.
I didn't ask you if he died. God saved him
God
or not?
God raised him again on the third day.
I didn't ask you if he raised him because he was asking for to save him. Did God save him?
Jesus did not ask. Jesus said, if it's possible to take this cup away from me.
He said that. I'm talking about this.
If it's possible, but if not, then
don't be dishonest. Don't be dishonest.
Right?
Don't be dishonest.
And God did what?
Don't be dishonest. I'm asking about Hebrews 5:7, when God clearly, or in the Bible says,
yes, God said it, okay, God heard him.
According to the Bible, anyone that is hanged is what? Is cursed. Correct?
Yes.
Genesis.
Yeah, Jesus was bearing the curse of God upon
He became
the cross.
Cursed. Jesus became cursed.
Jesus was bearing the curse that we deserve.
Watch this.
We are sinners. We should be cursed by God.
Jesus became cursed.
Jesus was taking the curse that we deserve.
I ask you, according to Paul, Jesus became cursed.
Right. He was cursed on our behalf.
Is it Satan cursed?
Pardon?
Is it Satan cursed?
Satan, it will be cursed by God and sent
is
to hell.
So it's not cursed? Yeah. Is it cursed?
Satan will be sent to hell.
Is it cursed, my question?
I would say that Satan is cursed.
So God is cursed and Satan is cursed. So who is God? Take care of yourself.
We should be cursed just like Satan. We should be cursed just like Satan,
because we're lying.
We should be cursed just like Satan.
So God is cursed and Satan is cursed. So they are friends.
Jesus bore the punishment for our sins.
We believe God is holy.
So
our God is holy.
Free.
Your God is cursed. Our God is holy.
We will be cursed.
Who cursed you, God?
Our trust in what Jesus.
So there is someone powerful than God who cursed him.
God the Father.
But like guys, you pray to God Abraham. I don't think you should pray to God Abraham because you believe he was adultery.
I would just ask you to consider if Jesus took our curse.
A big shout out to the person that suggested this. I'm literally just taken back, because this should be a point in which we should be learning from one another. But then this video was more about who's got the more points to disprove the other person. I wish they gave chance to each other to talk. If you're going to ask a question, let someone explain why they think so. And I feel like the missionaries' statements were ignored throughout. I was really starting to enjoy this Shamsi's videos. Otherwise, people believe in different things concerning marrying one or two wives, if not more. It's up to you, because then if you can, I think we've reacted something like this before, if you can marry more than one wife and take care of them, all is good and they're fine with it, all is good and well. But then if you think only one wife is okay, I think that's fine as well. I really can't criticize the person for thinking otherwise. Let me know what you guys think about this video. If there's anything else, let us know in the comment section below and we'll actually do it for you guys. And your response is actually welcome. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next reaction video.